He wanted it to start.
Look how much faster he got out. Boom! This is the race coaches are going to show their athletes for the next 50 years. That is the fastest human in history. Carl Lewis, only number two now, because Ben Johnson is now better than Carl has ever been.
A 9.84 at sea level.
You can't see this enough. Look how quickly Ben Johnson comes up. He hops up on both feet. And here, where Carl Lewis usually accelerates, Ben Johnson holds him off. Carl closes a little, but he was never going to get him. Never in doubt. That is an athlete, and Carl Lewis went to congratulate Ben Johnson, the better athlete on this day, and Carl really showed class by doing this. There is a man who has done what he set out to do. We have a new standard in starts established by Ben Johnson. He pulls his hands up, he hops up on both feet. Boom, look, they both leave the ground, and he's up and running faster than anyone else. He also has the fastest reaction time of anyone in the field. And now, he's nearly the fastest in the middle. Carl Lewis cannot catch him. Ben Johnson is the best in history, without a doubt.
Now we'll take another look in slow motion, and you can see it's even more vivid in slow motion as he just explodes. It's a leaping start out of the blocks for Ben Johnson, and the race in reality is over after 20 meters because he has the advantage with the start, and he is so quick, and he has peaked his whole career for today at this moment in time.
He's been a man with a mission. He's had an image to overcome, which is Carl Lewis's. He's very quiet. He's very sedate. He's got a great coach. He just decides what he's going to do. He sets out to do it. And now he's not only the strongest sprinter in the world, he's the fastest. And you can't see it enough. Watch him come up. Look how much quicker he moves. Boom, he's gone. You can see it right there. And that's the race. Now, Carl, I think at this point, thought he might be able to catch him. But look at Ben Johnson's eyes. He is just looking at the finish line.
The overhead view, and just for the record, Johnson, Lewis, Raymond Stewart of Jamaica finishes third, Linford Christie of Great Britain finishes fourth. But the story is Ben Johnson. Let's go down to Dwight Stone.
I'm down here with Carl Lewis. Carl, you told me that you think it's one of the worst races you ever run, but if I'm not mistaken, it's going to be very close to a world record. Talk us through your feelings from the time you came to set.
Well, Dwight, I came to set, I felt very good. But it's a gunshot. I just didn't really come up out of the blocks like I've been doing in the other qualifying rounds. And when you do that in a race like this, you just get left, and that was the difference. I'm really disappointed because my qualifying rounds were going very well, and I was ready to run very fast, and then we came to the final, and I didn't do it. But, hey, you can't take anything away from Ben. He ran a great race. He ran a great time, and he won today.
It seems as though the emotion shifted during the last 2 days from Ben Johnson to you. You became the favorite in the last 2 days. What could you have done differently?
Well, the only thing, like I said, is that I didn't really do what I had to do in the blocks. I mean, Ben has a great start, but I still believe I can come from behind. But I didn't do what I had to do in the blocks, and I got behind with the mistakes, and then I ran very hard to catch up, and then at the end, you just can't do it, so I stayed relaxed.
Was it tough to see him out there in front of you in the lane right next to you? He was almost running on the line next to you.
Well, it was very tough. I mean, especially since the fact that I knew I shouldn't have been that far behind. But like I said, you know, he ran 9.84, whatever the official time is, and it's faster than anyone has ever run. So, you know, he ran a great race. That's the lowdown.
The good news may be that you got at least an American record out of it.
Hopefully, and the one thing we know is that we have the Olympics, and that's my domain.
Absolutely. Back up to the booth. And, okay, I'm down here with a new world record holder in the 100 meters, Ben Johnson. Ben, a couple weeks ago, you said you thought if you ran the perfect race, you could run 9.85. You just ran 9.83.
When I'm freezing my time, I don't talk bullshit. Whenever I know I'm running, then I tell you if I'm running or not.
You look like you came out of the blocks very fast as usual, but you came out also very close to the line and then readjusted.
I came out so hard at the blocks. I end up in his lane, and I saw it, and then I back in the middle, I sort of maintain my position and my speed right through.
Did you feel that you really peaked properly for this meet, or is there more in Ben Johnson's legs, a faster time than that?
Well, hopefully next year I'll probably increase my speed and my endurance right to the race, but now I'm pleased with my time, and also, you know, world championship man, number one.
Congratulations, world champion, a new world record holder. Back up to Charlie Jones.
And our congratulations to Ben Johnson, the human being. He says it the way that it is. Also, as you know, he's been working on that speech impediment of his, and he has really improved. But what has improved? That 9.83. Carl Lewis second tied the old world record of 9.93. Greatest race in history. Let's go to Dickenberg.